G'day, Dad's Army, and welcome to my first look review on Rage. It's just going to be a first look review, which means I'm just going to tell you what I feel about the game as I play through it from the start. I'm not going to get enough time really to go through it totally to make sure that it's going to be more of a sort of an estimate of what I think the game will turn out to be. So let's get going, we'll check this out. It's got the normal controls, your brightness, different video settings. Controls, and yeah, there are stacks of downloadable content. I mean, totally stacks of downloadable content. Wow. they're looking for everyone to go out and buy a lot of stuff. Okay, I'll play it on the hardest setting, Nightmare. Should be pretty cool. Yeah, this is just your intro video at the start. I won't let it go for too long because we really want to get down and get into the gameplay, which is going to be hopefully excellent. Hopefully the hype isn't too much compared to the actual game, which sometimes can actually happen. This is still just sort of the intro video. I'll just show you a tiny bit, not to give too much away.
Cryogenic life support systems online. Subterranean launch injectors ready. 97% nominal.
At the start, you'll start in the Ark. And then set a head off from there, not knowing exactly what's actually going on. So
external disturbance detected.
That makes it even more interesting.
Cryogenic chambers compromised. Chamber Omega 5 online. Initiating emergency nanotrite activation. 3, 2, 1. Nanotrite sequencer online. Release cryogenic chamber seals.
This part of the game is really just to get you used to your controls, looking up and down, and making sure they're set correct, and then get you going. Just remember, in this game you can pretty well save any time you want, so make sure at least after a really hard battle you save, so you don't have to go and do it again.
Remote location beacon offline.
Let's check outside. Ah, that's how you hit your switches. Hit A. Not exactly sure what that did. Did something. That's not even plugged in, so that's not really going to help anyone. Okay, outside we go. Okay, that is what it looks like outside. It looks quite beautiful, the graphics. I'd give it at least a good 8.5 out of 10. The only thing I found with the graphics are, from a distance they look really good, but close up they don't quite look as well detailed as you would expect. Yeah, kind of fuzzy. But if anything, very convincing. That's one of the guys you'll meet up with during the game, and kill many of the old bandits. And here comes your saviour. Comes the John Goodman. Yeah. Mr. Goodman is voicing this guy. As soon as you hear his voice, you'll know who he is.
It ain't safe here. Get in. I know you got questions.
These cars are disappointing, not just the controls, just the way they sound. They sound like a ride-on mower with one cylinder barely going. Is this the town? There's a shop there to buy your weapons. The girl's just over there who gives you weapons.
We need to talk. Head to where those bandits live and wipe them out, plain and simple. No one walks out alive, except you. You can use one of my ATVs in the garage, and that pistol, and the supplies on the table. Oh, and you won't just get my thanks. One more thing. Those bandits shouldn't be too hard to take down. Not for you. I hear there's something special about you,
Arthur. Get our ammo and our gun and get going on by. Handling of the vehicles are pretty basic. I mean, it's quite basic. Not great, but good enough. Just. That's where you go to pick up different information that's sort of mailed to you, races and different things. Now, from now on, I'm just going to sit back and let you watch a bit of gameplay and battle play against some of these bandits, and I'll tell you what I think near the end, unless I can see something to point out. The controls, once you get used to them, are reasonably fluid, not quite as fluid as you'd probably expect. Definitely the enemy do exactly what id said they'd do. They jump and bounce off walls and throw things at you and are quite hard to kill, especially on the harder setting. Very acrobatic. I did find using the pistol a bit weird, it just didn't feel quite right, which feels kind of odd being id involved in shooters. I'm not quite sure why, it just didn't quite feel right, but that might be just the first weapon I get. Until I get further into the game, I won't be totally sure. But definitely,
good.
Once you get used to the controls.
I like my prey to know what's coming. I promise this will hurt.
Once you get used to the controls, it's very easy to be able to control the character. This is what happens anytime you die. It's like a defibrillator. It's like a mini game. I got to admit, it's the most annoying mini game I've ever seen in my whole life. I am going to really hate it. It'd be great if it wasn't there, because I kind of can't work out why it's there. Once you get used to it, you work out what to do. Throughout the game, you'll catch up with people in the town where I picked up the gun and the motorcycle, or the quad bike. There are towns spread out throughout the different maps. The game isn't as open world as you think it is. It's virtually, if you look down from the top of this game, it would be a heap of different circles where the towns are, and canyons that run between the towns, and you drive between the towns to get your different missions depending on how you go from town to town. So don't expect it to be like some Far Cry Fallout game. It is not. It slightly leads you where you are to go, but you can choose which mission you wish to play, so that makes it a bit less linear. even though it kind of is. Gameplay, I would probably give it an 8 out of 10, and about an 8 for graphics, mostly because the way they were hyping about the graphics, they do look really good, but it's just odd how closer up they don't quite look as good as they should. I suppose that's just being critical, but I suppose the way they were hyping it out, it just sounded like it was going to be this magical, wonderful world. And it's almost, but not quite.
Where are the others?
Shopkeeper. That's where you buy your ammo and bits and pieces, including your throwing weapon, which is the one everyone sees and
hope you do business with you again.
Seems to love this.
Here are the rules.
Where you get your wing stick practice.
And hit him as quickly as you can.
Once you've done this, you're allowed to go out and buy some wing sticks. Love my wing stick. Just back into another mission. I thought I'd show you as much action as I possibly can, so you can get to see how it plays. Even when you wound them, they'll try to kill you.
Thank you.
That's their toilet. Beautiful. Love that smell. Oh my god. Okay, back in the town. I'd give the game a good 8, 8.5 out of 10. It hasn't quite met the hype that the game has had leading up until now with what I can see. There are some minor things that should have been done slightly better, but I'd give it a good 8, 8.5 out of 10. Definitely if you like this style of game, you'll enjoy it once you get used to the controls. Catch you later, guys. Bye.